Hi, my name is Sven, welcome back to the channel. Today we are looking at a new tool that I built called the NOIR Channel Split. And it is a really simple tool that shows us the individual color channels. And because I want to see everybody use it, you can get it for free on my website. So more on that later, but let's talk about what it does. So first of all, let's briefly talk about color channels. Each image consists of three channels, red, green, and blue, and the balance between those creates the colors that we can see on the display. Let's define them in a range between 0 and 1. 0 would be black, and 1 would be white. And if each channel showed the same values at the same time, we would get a grayscale image. So essentially you could say, the more different the channels are, the more saturated an image becomes. So why do we look at individual channels? First of all, we have to understand that the green channel is the most important regarding luminance, and that's just because of how our eyes work. We are most sensitive to green colors, and because of this behavior, cameras actually take more care of the green channel than of the other two. The blue channel is the least important for luminance, which is why you will usually see the lowest quality in this channel. Just compare the different amounts of noise in this image, and this was shot with a high-end ARRI camera. So, with this knowledge in mind, we should also discuss negative values, because it can happen, especially with color management and color space conversions, that certain colors produce values in one or more channels that are in fact not between 0 and 1, but negative. And this is a common problem with highly saturated colors and neon highlights, especially when working with ASUS, but also with other color management systems. In order to find those colors, we could either look at the parade, it shows us the content of each channel as a two-dimensional graph, and see if there's anything going below the lowest limit of the scope. A different and in my opinion more user-friendly way would be to look at each channel, which we can by clicking on this menu and selecting View Channel and then red or green or blue. So we can see that the blue channel here contains very dark values, even though it should be a bright light source. And we call this an out of gamut color, and you can learn more about that in the video linked above. But just so you know, we can fix them with the ASUS Transform OFX, and more on that in this video. Now, as I said, one way to look at the channels would be with this menu, but this actually only shows you the content of the channel after the final color conversion. Even in highlight mode, so we are looking only at this node, it still applies the ODT in a color managed project. So you can't see the signal at this stage, but only at the stage after the ODT, which can be totally different, and this is why I built this DCTL. So what does it do? This DCTL will split the image into its individual color channels in four different modes. Either as a split screen mode with red in the top left corner, green in the top right, and blue in the bottom left corner. Or you can also look at each channel individually with this dropdown. And this checkbox lets you tint those channels in their respective color, but by default they show in black and white because it's easier on the eyes. All of that could be created with Resolve's own tools, but I found that to be a bit complicated, so that's why I built it into this DCTL. But that's also why you can download it for free. The main benefit of using my DCTL instead of the View Channels dropdown, however, is that you can place it anywhere in the node tree. With highlight mode enabled, you can exactly see the current state of the image. But also, as you can see in this example, it's pretty cool to see all the channels at the same time here, because we can instantly tell where the problem of this color lies. So if you enjoyed this tool, you can get it for free on my website, and the link is in the video description. Just let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and also please leave a like on this video and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss on upcoming videos. And until then, I'll see you in the next episode.